So, today we will look how to groom the hat as I promised. So, we will start to finish some rest of the coat to strip off. For this, I'm using the Diamond Fine, the undercoat remover knife, which is very good for the details on the hat. So I will just clean a little there and there before we start the machine work. All this actually from the eye has to go out, so we are wooling a little and then stripping all this mess away up to the ears and on the side. As well on the other side, you can see here. It's really a great detailer, this knife. It goes to the total fine details. We are stripping between the eyebrows. All this must go off, otherwise there will be some sharpie coat, and this we don't want, so. See all this. I sometimes use the Diamond Edition, the stripping knife, coarse. For taking out the details, you see how well it's taking. And as well here on the sides and on top of the head, so we have a smooth line. All the way here and to the ears and behind the ears. You can see nicely how we cleaned all this. Maybe we can take a little from the undercoat there. This I'm taking the Retro Edition knife. Just to clean the rest and take a little of the undercoat here. You be careful between the eyes because it's a little sensitive area. So, a little here of the sticking out. I barely use scissors actually around the eyes. So, you see, I use the Diamond knife to take the total details in the eye corners. You can use edge of the knife and just pull all this hair, which has nothing to do there. So, here we go. Now you can nicely see the stripped area between the eyebrows. So this we have very nicely done. We have to have the beard brushed through, so no filters anywhere, no mats. You better use the comb just to be sure. This is our comb with the rolling teeth. It's very smart because it's not pulling out any hair, it's just going smoothly through. See, nicely. We have prepared the beard for it. now we will start the machine work on the ears and the cheeks and everything. So I start with the number 10. And follow with the ear out. No. Now we start on the throat from the edge where the chest bone torches is starting. We are taking and up. We can smoothly go with the strip areas and behind the ear. When you take the ear like this, clean so you can see nicely on the neck to make the smooth line. That's it. But don't go much into the strip area. You see, you find the eye, through the eye, and through the eye here. Smooth a little bit here, and here we have the rest. And then you find the eye. Up with the ear. And smooth through the neck. Okay. Still a little here and there. Mm-hmm. So, now we got the head clipped on the sides. We will brush it to see a little more. Now we straighten on the ears. Be careful with that because it can go quickly. You just feel where is edge of the ear. Be careful not to crop them. So it's okay. And the other ear. So we have him nice and nothing is sticking anywhere. Oh, here we go. And a little inside. It should be pulled a little, but not much because then they are scratching in it and whatever. So here we have the ears and the start of the head. Now I will take the diamond edition knife and strip a little on the connection parts so it's perfectly smooth. Nothing should stick up. You see, here is a little, this I will take fillers for. Just a little bit of thinners to smooth the edges as well here and as well here. And on the sides, because I never dare really to go with the machine to the total edge because it's easy to make a damage. He will move and it takes half a year before it will grow up, so. And here a little, just the edges. So, yeah. We have the eyebrows ready for work now. And here you see on the neck is a little mess, so I take the coarse from the retro edition and I will tan it like this, the head, to make smooth, because it shouldn't be just bush compared to the clipped area, so. I strip the edges and I use a lot of removing the undercoat. So we get a smooth, lovely way from the neck and from the throat nicely to the stripped area. Here he has a little more, so. Removing of the undercoat there. These knives are just God's gift to anyone who wants to work perfection, because you can work with one knife actually everything if you want to. And then I will roll a little on the neck to get it smoother. Good boy. And for the rest, you just take the thinners. I will kill the dog. Yeah, that's a schnauzer. They will bark and they will bark. Red, Red, stop it. So now we smooth the neck nicely. You can see how lovely it became. You can of course choose to throw the, to strip everything on the throat and the sides, but on dog which has a lot of undercoat like he has, it will be a little hard. And you also must be careful not to make some bald parts, especially before the show. So I prefer to clip it with the machine and then just smooth maybe with the lava stone. Well, let's look at the eyebrow. This is a little different point in Europe and in America. We do it differently. So I will do the European as I'm used, because in America they do that it, the edge should follow end of the ear. But they can afford it because the ears are very elegant, but we need a little slimmer in the eyebrows, because with the bigger ears it's not looking so nice if you make it short and broad. So I prefer always to make them slimmer and just cover the eye and follow with the line of the head, so it's going actually in very nice smooth way from the inner side of the ear, not the out part of the ear as the American do. So we brush it nicely. He had been bathed and with conditioner and everything, so it should be nice. I didn't use any chalk or any hairspray or anything, so we just work the nature coat. And we start from the out and give it the first, always clip a little under, because then it's lifting the. And then I start to find the first form. By the eye corner. So in the moment I have the eye corner fixed like this, then I smooth it a little. And then from there it's easier to follow the line. And of course you must remember each dog is different, so each dog need more or less of the eyebrow. It's never universal recipe. You have to work with the shape of the head. He has beautiful long head, so by him it's actually you can do whatever. So this dog is ideal model for really ideal for anything you want to try in the grooming, because he's so universal in the standard shape. So you can make him in the elegant way or in the more old-fashioned way. You see, I never use long scissors for the eyebrow. I better do it little by little with smaller to avoid any mistake. We will do the other one. This is not so easy because there you have to clip the other way. So you first, as I said, clean out the eye. So you have some line to go after. can see how it helped already. It looks like a little hack here, and this is helping you to keep the line. So here we go. I know it looks easy because I have been grooming so many, so we will correct a little. It's still sticking a little out here, so this I would fix a little better, and here a little. Voila, go. So it's lovely. I think now we got it. And then of course you should use a little gel to fix it, or a little hairspray, whatever. Otherwise it will blow. Just a kind of gel can stiff it enough. Because then they shake head and you have it all over, so a little help. Now I can see a little under the throat. We need to so here you see the head. You anyway still correct on it, even on the dog show. You know, you think you made the dog to perfection, then you come there and you still work on it. I'm gonna cut the edges off. Lie down. Stay, just stay. You see nicely. It's looking. The ball head. And smooth of the neck. Look, see here, look, up here, you can see clean the undercoat on the head. Smooth to the cheeks, clip to the eye corner and down and under to the edge. The eyebrows you saw, so I think the head is done now, and I will continue. We will look how to work the coat after some time, so it will be in the next video.